you're not supposed to worry about how the clocks got set, right? They just did get set. When everything's working properly and I'm doing my job, you don't know anything about it.
Are you wearing a watch?
Yeah, I don't wear a watch because it's too compulsive.
That's Judah Levine.
It makes you look at the watch all the time and you kind of go a little crazy.
His nickname is literally the nation's Time Lord.
I mean, that comes from Doctor Who, all right? If you've ever watched Doctor Who. I don't remember who made me the Time Lord. I think it's unfair to all my colleagues, okay?
Do you have a TARDIS?
No, I don't have a TARDIS, okay? Only Doctor Who has a TARDIS.
Okay, fair enough. But there's a reason he got that nickname. Judah's job is to officially keep time standard. He works here at the National Institute of Standards and Technology. It's a government agency that maintains standards of all quantities, such as length, speed, and, well, time.
In the old days, which means like 100 years ago, time was something that was astronomical. It was sunrise or sunset or noon or whatever. In the more modern era, time is something defined by atomic clocks, which provide a very stable reference frequency.
Atomic clocks are the most accurate way to tell time on Earth. 45 years ago, Judah and a team of scientists at NIST developed a system for the atomic clock that tracks time more accurately than ever before in the US, linking all phones, power grids, financial markets, you name it. Every day, he checks to make sure the systems are calibrated, ensuring that time is right on schedule.
These are the atomic clocks. This is the real stuff. Okay.
What if we switched off the atomic clock? What if it just stops working?
Certainly, cell phone systems stop pretty much right away. The internet stops pretty quickly. High-end tech stuff would suffer very quickly.
But that's probably not going to happen.
There are 400 atomic clocks in many timing laboratories. I don't think we're ever going to intentionally switch off all of the atomic clocks. I mean, that's an unthinkable event.
If you say so, Judah. After all, you're the reason we all know what time it is.